altar which was supposed to burn with the fire of the Spirit. When the fire of the Spirit is gone, what is left out is ashes. Many people think because they are baptized, the ash is left out, the name is left out, I am a Christian, so God will protect. No. Not only Christian, I am saying, not a priest, not a bishop, anybody to that matter, not the white garment that is going to save you. You keep alive the fire of the Lord, the enemy will be kept out of you. If you don't keep the fire of the Lord, next minute, the enemy snake will be on your table to play with you, to eat up the ashes. So being with the fire is not a need. It's a must. It is a survive for your survival. You have to keep alive the fire. That's why St. Paul says, whether you eat or drink, do everything with thanksgiving. Move with his presence. 1 Corinthians 10:31. That's why he says, every minute, call upon the Spirit. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 to 8. Every minute, call upon the Holy Spirit. Then what will happen? As we read in Romans 8:14, the Spirit of God will join with your spirit. What is your spirit? Holy Spirit, I need you. Oh, fire of God, I need you. If your spirit is crying for that, the Holy Spirit will join with your spirit and he will make you the children of God. It is there we become the children of God, not by baptism. Baptism is a public approval of your parents. Let my children live as a Catholic or as a Christian children. It is every moment. Christianity is not a religion. It's a way of life. It's a commitment of life to move with the Spirit of God, to move with the vision of God, to move with the plan and purpose of God, to live the life of God. God is calling each one of us for this glorious purpose. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, God is calling us. So the Spirit of the Lord doesn't give us the fear. Now Elijah, he got up early morning and he bound. He bound every power of darkness. And once he bound the place, filled the place with the power of the Holy Spirit, no evil can dare to enter into. This is the secret. This is the secret we need to learn. We need to understand. Yes. When he was filled, when the place was filled with the Holy Spirit, the enemies could not come inside. The next day, the 420 Paul prophets, they came, they prayed with all their prayers. When there is already light, darkness has no place to enter. Darkness cannot pierce, cannot come in only one place, where there is light. Where a person is moving with the presence of God, where a person carries the presence of God, the enemy has no power to enter into. So Christian life is, Christian call is to be conscious of the Spirit and celebrate the Spirit. Man has to learn it is. Spirit of God gives us not fear, rather other three powers to be empowering oneself in the Spirit. To make oneself as a loving being of the Holy Spirit. And to discipline oneself constantly to be in the presence of God. So the life of the Holy Spirit means, read once again that word, 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, not to simply throw away one's life, a precious life which Christ bought us with his own precious blood. Throw away for anything and everything. That if the fear, the worries, the pain, the sickness, the need of the world simply comes and captures you and pulls you, no. Rather, spirit of power, to move with power of God. So when you see the pain, you stand like a soldier. The soldier never sees an enemy and runs away, then he is not a soldier for the nation. If he loves the nation, he goes even to say, give his life, but his whole aim is to finish up the enemy, to protect his nation, not himself. So, power means, here the power means, empower yourself with the truth. What is the truth? Your God is a loving Father. He has brought you into the world. You are alive because His breath is in you. If He doesn't want you, He would have taken the breath from you. 1 second is enough for Him. A small accident is enough. A small heart attack is enough. If He is making you to be alive, means He wants you. Every child comes with the good news. God still loves the world. So you have to fill yourself with that love. The enemy's game is to take away the love of God from you. To make you to think you are a miserable being. You are a helpless being. You are a defeated being. No. Be empowered with the power of God. Your God is all powerful. Your God is all knowing. Your God is a loving Father. Yes. When you have that knowledge of God burning in you, you move. We are not called to be frightened people, but to empower ourselves with the love of God, with the power of God, constantly discipline. I feel like going, immediately ask the Holy Spirit, discipline myself. Can I go, Holy Spirit? No, over. Nothing more, nothing less. Every decision of my life is constantly taken to the Holy Spirit, spoken to Holy Spirit, heard the voice of the Holy Spirit, and obey the Holy Spirit. That's why Jesus said in John 15:7, if you remain in me, and my words finds home in you, whatever you ask, I will give it to you. When his word is being obeyed and followed, what we ask is heard. Why our prayers are not heard? Check whether what we pray is according to His will, according to His voice. So God has not given us the spirit of fear. Enemy will come when you are weak. When you are weak, when you don't pray, when you are sleepy, when you are lethargic, when you are covered, He will come and attack you. When you are weak. Now, Elijah won the battle. The enemies could not bring fire. So he prayed to the Holy Spirit. Fire came. Now Elijah became Zindabad. Sab log bolte hain, kya? Elijah, Zindabad. Elijah, Zindabad. And the process he forgot to celebrate the Holy Spirit who gave him the victory. Many people move with God to achieve them something, and the moment they achieved, they just move with themselves. Instead of holding on to the Spirit and celebrating the Spirit, read the book of Proverbs chapter 8. Verse 30. What is the loving? Filling yourself with love means what? It is not that you love God, but you are satisfied in the love of God. Happy are those. God is honored when we are satisfied with Him. Tell your heart, God is honored when I am satisfied with Him. God rejoices when I am satisfied with Him. Yes. I am not asking God to make me happy, but I make my God happy. I make my life. The purpose of my life is to make my God happy, delightful, rejoicing.